I hope it's not too much. Now, we have to take the help of the Mother Earth, so if you could take out the shoes, it will be much better. Just the shoes, not the socks, but just the shoes. Please come in, there's a lot of space here. Yes, just come. Sit down. Modern yoga is very wonderful, I think, that sitting on the chair you can get your realization. You don't have to do all kinds of asanas. It had to be that way. Now, please remember, as I told you, this left and right side, there are two powers. The left side power is the power of desire, not of pure desire, but desire. The right side is the power of action. So we have to keep both our feet little away from each other. We have to sit comfortably, not bending too much or putting yourself backward too much, but just in a straight manner. And put your left hand towards me like this. This means that you want your self-realization, that you desire your self-realization. Just like this, very comfortably, please put your left hand towards me like this. And with the right hand, we'll be nourishing our centers. So right hand you have to put on your heart. We work only on the left hand side. I'll first show you and then we'll close our eyes and we'll work out the awakening of the Kundalini. Now in the heart resides the spirit. So first we put our hand on the spirit. Then we put our hand on the upper portion of our abdomen on the left hand side. Now this is the center of your mastery. That means by awakening this center you get that power by which you can master the art of Kundalini awakening. Then you take down your hand in the low portion of your abdomen and press it hard. This is the center of pure knowledge. The pure knowledge is that knowledge that you get out of your evolutionary process which manifests on your nervous system, on your central nervous system. Then again you have to raise your hand in the upper portion of your abdomen. And then on your heart again. Then raise your right hand in the corner of your neck, here. Neck and your shoulder, and turn your head to your right. This is the center which I told you just now is completely disturbed when you feel guilty. And I think today, with all of you, it has this problem. So again I'll say, please, please, forgive yourself. Then you have to take your right hand onto your forehead across, like this, and press it on both the sides. Put down your head and press it nicely. This is the center for forgiving others. Take back your right hand on the back side of your head and push back your head on it. Let it rest. Here, for your own satisfaction, without counting your mistakes, without feeling guilty, you have to ask forgiveness from the divine power which is all-pervading. Now you have to stretch your hand fully and put the center of your palm on top of the fontanel bone area, which was a soft bone in your childhood. Please put it there exactly. Put down your head nicely. Put down your head. Now, push back your fingers as much as you can. Put down your head and push back your fingers. Now push your hand on the scalp nicely so it gives some pressure. And now you have to move your scalp very slowly, clockwise, 7 times. Now, this is all we have to do. You can take out your spectacles also, it might help your eyesight. So please take out your spectacles. Now again I repeat, you have to be pleasantly placed towards yourself. Don't feel guilty. You have done nothing wrong in the eyes of the Divine. Please now put your left hand towards me and right hand on your heart, both the feet apart, and now close your eyes. Here, you have to ask a very fundamental question to me. You may call me Sri Mataji or Mother, whatever you like. Mother, am I the Spirit? Ask this question 3 times. Mother, am I the Spirit? Please ask this question 3 times in your heart. Now, if you are the Spirit, you are your Master, you are your guide. So take down your right hand, the upper portion of your abdomen on the left hand side, press it hard and here ask me another very fundamental question in your heart. Mother, am I my own Master? Mother, am I my own Guru? Ask this question 3 times. As I have told you that I respect your freedom and I cannot force pure knowledge on you. You have to ask for it. So now take down your right hand, the lower portion of your abdomen, press it hard on the left hand side and here you please say 6 times because this center has got 6 petals. Mother, please give me pure knowledge. This knowledge has to manifest on your central nervous system, giving you a new dimension. Ask earnestly. As soon as you ask this question, the Kundalini starts rising. So now we have to nourish the upper centers to open the passage for Kundalini to rise. So now you raise your right hand onto the upper portion of your abdomen. Now press it hard on the left hand side. Here now with full confidence in yourself, please say, Mother, I am my own Master. Please say it. 10 times, because this center has got 10 petals. Please say it with full confidence, Mother, I am my own Master. As I have told you in the very beginning, that the truth is you are not this body, and you are not this intellect, you are not these emotions, and you are not these conditionings or this ego. You are the pure spirit. So now please raise your right hand on your heart and say it again with full confidence 12 times. Mother, I am the spirit. Mother, I am the spirit. Please say it 12 times. The divine power, which is all-pervading, is the ocean of knowledge and of love. It is the ocean of benevolence and blessings. But above all, it is the ocean of forgiveness. So, whatever mistakes you might have committed, this ocean of forgiveness has a power to dissolve everything. So please forgive yourself. Forgive yourself. Be pleasantly placed towards yourself. And put your right hand in the corner of your neck and your shoulder and turn your head to your right. Here you have to say with full confidence, Mother, I am not guilty at all. Please say it 16 times, because this center has got 16 petals. Mother, I am not guilty at all. I have already told you that whether you forgive or don't forgive, you don't do anything. But if you don't forgive, then you play into wrong hands and suffer. So now raise your right hand on top of your forehead and put down your head on your hand properly. Press it on both the sides nicely and say it from your heart. Mother, I forgive everyone. I'm saying, say it from your heart. Not how many times, but say it from your heart. Mother, I forgive everyone. Now, take back your hand on the back side of your head and push back your head on that hand nicely, let it rest. Here, please again remember, do not count your mistakes. Do not feel guilty at all, but just for your satisfaction, you push back your head nicely and say, O Divine Power, if I have done any mistakes, knowingly or unknowingly, please forgive me. Now, please stretch your hand, your palm fully, put the center of your palm on top of your fontanel bone area, which was the soft bone in your childhood. Push back your fingers and press your scalp nicely. Here again, I cannot cross over your freedom. You have to ask for self-realization. So now please put down your head and press it hard and move it 7 times, your scalp, very slowly with a pressure pushing back your fingers. And here you have to say 7 times, Mother, please give me my Self-Realization. Put down your head nicely. Please, Mother, give me my Self-Realization. 7 times. Please take down your hands and open your eyes. Now, put both your hands towards me. Now try to think. Now watch me without thought. You can do it. You can watch me without thought. This is the first state you achieve, called as thoughtless awareness. Now, put your right hand like this. And right hand like this, and left hand on top of your head, and put it down your head, and put your right hand, and see for yourself, not on the head, but above the head, and see for yourself if there's a cool breeze coming out of your head. Put down your head. Please put your right hand like this. Now, please put your left hand towards me and put down your head and see for yourself if there is a cool breeze coming out of your head. With the right hand you can feel it. Now, don't put it on top. You have to put it above it, little away. Some people might get hot heat coming out, that's all right. And some people might get it far away. Doesn't matter, if there's a heat coming out, is all right, the heat has to come out. Now please put again the right hand, bend your head again and see for yourself if there's a cool breeze coming out of your head. Now, please raise both of your hands, like this. Push back your head and ask a question 3 times, any one of these. Mother, is this the cool breeze of the Holy Ghost? Mother, is this the power of love of God? Mother, is this the all-pervading Parama Chaitanya? Ask any one of these questions 3 times. Now don't doubt, because there's air conditioning, you may doubt, but there's nothing to doubt about it. Good. Now take down your hands. All those who have felt the cool breeze or the heat or the cool in their hands, out of their heads or on their hands, please raise both your hands. All those who have felt it, cool breeze out of your head or in your hands. It's very good. May God bless United Nations. Most of you have felt it. Some have not, doesn't matter. It doesn't mean that something's wrong with you. But we have a club here, thank God this is being registered. You are all welcome. And we have great experts of Sahaja Yoga in New York. That's one thing I must say. We have a great experts of Sahaja Yoga, and they'll tell you each and everything about it, the whole knowledge. Don't have to pay for it. Only a little bit time you have to give. These days we have watches to save time, but we save time to waste it. We have to save time to use it for our ascent. And you don't need much time for this. About 5 minutes in the morning and 10 minutes in the evening is more than sufficient. But you must first learn, and you all must become great masters of sadhana. Next time when I come, I hope I'll be able to see lots of people who have got realization through you. May God bless you.
One additional question in regarding to this self-realization. When people ask me what do I do as a Sahaja Yogi, I had explained what do we do with what you just showed us to do. But they asked me what is this based on to make it work. If this isn't an appropriate question, then forgive me. But
it's a state. It's a state of our being. And one's first state is of thoughtless awareness. Second one is doubtless awareness. So you have to rise up to that. And then you know everything yourself. I mean, it's not much to be explained because it becomes part and parcel of… Like, I can see clearly this carpet in the same way. I can clearly feel when I'm a realized soul about everything. So they have to rise up to that level, but not blindly.